Okay, thanks for the introduction, and all previous speakers already told you the importance of lipid identification softwares and for unmodified lipids. And I will be talking about more about oxidized lipids. And the tool we call is the LPB Tiger. I will give you some introduction about the basics, about special criteria and challenges we're facing for the oxidized lipids identification. And then we give you a short tutorial about the softness. So after the previous several days talk, we're already aware that lipids are very diverse in structures, but they can be from the same elemental composition. And from the same mass, they can have different structures already, but it's situation become more complicated when it become oxidized. And we also know that by LC chromatography, we can separate these isomers in different rotation times. And we also have the knowledge that they have different, similar, but different fragmentation patterns, which reveal their slightly different structures. And we also know that they have potentially different functions. So it's very important to identify these oxidations on the fatty acid level. And the identification for oxidized lipids is quite challenging because we are facing a much more complex structures and much, much higher number of possible structures. And these have another issues for the identification software, because you can have isomers, that means the same elemental composition but different structures, and they are closely or co-elution, then the fragmentation pattern may overlap. And you also have isobaric species which have the same nominal mass and also probably co-eluting, and then the identification has some certain challenges to face. So we have in summary, the search space issue, and then we need more complex identification algorithms. So let's have a look of the first search space issues. So the lipid maps and other databases probably tells you the unmodified lipids around 10 to the 5, yeah? And then if you enumerate all possible modifications and including all this possible ring structures, the numbers will bump up to e to the 10, which is enormous. But the actual lipid dome, which you can possibly acquire and report, is probably thousands or tens of thousands. So there's a huge gap. If you find to use this number to identify the actual epilipidome, then you probably have one MOZ versus 1,000 or more possible candidate structures. So there's overfitting and increase a lot false positive rate and waste lots of computing power. One alternative way is we take what we identified from the unmodified lipids, which usually the current publications usually report hundreds or less than 2,000 unmodified lipids. And then we oxidize them based on certain rules to get more relevant theoretical epilipidome. This, we get the numbers much smaller and then much more relevant. For example, single myelins have more saturated lipids and less oxidized. So we can have more relevant search space and get better results. The LPB Tiger software is designed to identify oxidized lipids to prove this concept. So first we take the specific lipidome and then perform in silico oxidation to get this theoretical structure space. And then we can perform in silico fragmentation based on the fragmentation patterns we summarize. And then we can identify them using these five criteria score systems, which I will explain to you later. So the first step is the prediction. In this prediction, we summarize from the publications from enzymatic and unenzymatic approaches, and then to get the possible structures from different fatty acids. And then we also summarize the possibilities of each kind of modifications. So you can decide you go for the most common ones, or for the some pathway dependent, or for less reported modifications as well. You can also select if you oxidize only one fatty acid from the phospholipids, or if you think that two fatty acid residues will both get oxidized. This will change very much the number of the search space. This is an example. So this is PAPE. We have 20 carbon, four double bonds here in this structure. We take these fatty acids, and then there are four double bond units. We take one of them, and it can go for the oxygen addition or just cleavage from here. If it's not cleavage, then we can go to the next double bond and so on. And then since there are more than three double bonds, it can also go possible prostate structure. And then after a final control, then we can from one structure, we get 105 possible products and with 48 unique MOZ. And then we can go through all different candidates and then get our specific epilipidome, which we use later for identification. We also do is we manually assign lots of oxidized spectra and to collect these fragmentation patterns. That means we have the MOZ intensity and we know what is that. And then we collect this knowledge and perform in silico fragmentation, which well explained by the previous talk also in MS Diet. And then we have the overall workflow. So we have the unoxidized lipidome. You can get it from different softwares. You submit to LPV Tiger to generate this predicted oxidized lipid space. We take the spectra from your mass spec. We first will get extracted ion chromatogram. Then we will check the isotope patterns and then check the fragmentation patterns. And then we generate a report for you. For the assignment, we have our special five score systems. The first score is the isotope score. This is very important to see if it's actually the exact elemental composition. This is a simple example, very common case for lipids that you have two more hydrogens. That means one less saturation. Then you have overlaps of the isotope pattern. So LPP Tiger is able to do that. And we have to also aware that there's also other possibilities. For example, sphingomyelin myelins are overlapped with phosphatidylcholines, also like this complex isotope patterns. So based on this isotope score, we can clearly say the elemental composition of the precursor. And then come the second, more or less rule-based rank score. In these score systems, I'm just explaining brief. So we are not using the exact intensity of these fragments, but we are rather taking the ranks. So we are comparing fragments versus fragments candidates and neutral loss fragments, neutral loss ions against other neutral loss ions. And then in this way, we are more tolerant to different instrument settings and low abundant signals. In this way, we can collect the information from the fragments and neutral losses for the fatty acid residues and then reassemble the whole structure of oxidized lipids. And then we have also include the in silico fragmentation, which we mentioned previously. Then we can do a reverse dot similarity comparison between the in silico fragmentation pattern and the experiment spectra. For this, we collect more than 500 manually assigned spectra and we can be more confident with this fragmentation pattern matching. And all previous scores about more intense signals, but for the oxidized lipids, we have the neutral loss of water and additional fragments, which are not that intense. So we introduce this fingerprint score, which is just checking the MOZ, which is not intensity dependent. For this one, we can distinguish whether there are hydroxy groups or, for example, is ketyl groups, which do not have the neutral loss. And when we summarize all these different criteria together, we can get more confident identification of the structure to identify the type of the modifications. This is the software interface. We have a user-friendly software interface and free to download with the link. And then we also give you a graphic report. You can open the browser to check your identification results. And the scores which I showed in previous slides are located here for each identification. So when you search LPP Tiger from Google, and then you can get this major many links. If you want to download it, you go to the SpeedMarket link here, and then you go to the source code website. But for today, as our tutorials, we are using mostly probably Windows from the researchers. Then you click here, and then you come to this Windows version page. And then you click here for the download page, and then here the files for you. For today, I've prepared a version for this Spring School, and then the tutorial package and the user guide. If you download the tutorial package and the user guide, you get a list of folders. This includes step-by-step user guide with screenshots and examples. And in each folder, we have the sample files and sample output from each step. Today, I will give you just a short overview how it will work. And then you can download this tutorial pack and then try it yourself. So if you download the software, you don't need to install. You just unzip it, and then you can find two exes. It's just a normal one and a debug. If you start the normal one, you get only this window, the main window. If you start this debug mode, you will have additional window to monitor what is going on behind the software. Then we can start. The first step is to predict or to generate a theoretical epilipidome. We have, if you open the tutorial file, we have the template. In this tutorial, we prepare just two simple lipids, and then which represent the reported lipidome. And then you open the software, you put this Excel, and you select the class. And then you can define the oxidation levels, how many maximum modifications. You can control the ketyl groups, hydroperoxy groups. You can disable peroxies. And you can decide whether you want to generate in silico fragmentation pattern or not. And then you can save it as an MSP file, which explained by MSDIA. And then you can generate, just click start. It will generate the theoretical epilipidome. For this step, you will get four different outputs. The examples are in the second folder. The first one is called SDF format. You can download this tool, it's for free from Nonlinear. And then you can open this SDF files for ChemDraw or other SDF compatible software. You can see the predicted structures, the names, the MOZs, the elemental composition, and additional information which we predicted. Then there are two Excels. One is for the names which you defined, for the abbreviations of all the lipids, the precursor MOZ, and all the information you can find in these SDF files as well. And then we have additional file called FASAM, which consists of all the fatty acid residues for the phospholipids part. And these files will be used later for identification. We also generate additional files. The MSP library is basically consists of the precursor type, MOZ formula, and MOZ of the fragments, and the intensity, and also some remarks. This for you to easily look at it. You can open it by any text editor, for example, Notepad, or other MSP compatible software. So these are the four major predicted output. You can use SDF files from a structured database. You can use these two files to generate a DDA inclusion list for later analysis, or you can use this MSP file for other compatible software. You can also use these two files for later identification using the raw spectra, which converted to MZML spectra, and then use the identification function from LPP Tiger. LPP Tiger is designed for identification. That's why we are not able to do quantification here, but there are plenty of quantification softwares, which you heard from previous talks. And the MZML format is the common vendor-free format. You download this Proteo Wizard software from the website. You select MZML and 32-bit format, and then click convert. We provide you a sample MZML file in the tutorial folder. And then you can put start the software. You select this tutorial for files from Waters, and you select LCMS and phosphatidylcholines. You select these two Excels and the MZML file. And then you select where to save this output, and then the Excel summary table. And then there are some general parameters about the 10 time range, MOZ, PPMs, and certain thresholds. And then you can click here just to hunt for oxidized lipids. The software might not responding because the time of processing is very long. But if you are running the debug mode, you can see the software is trying to find something, already matching something, get some score, or generating the images. When the run is finished, it will be displayed here. Then it says finished. And then some common issue, you are not getting the report because there's error from the MZML conversion. This is because MZMLs are updated several times per year. And then if you are using the Proteo Wizard version, which is working for LPP Tiger, or other tools, we recommend you to keep that version for the whole project. Then you have the same version of MZML files. There's no problem. We are releasing these OBO patches from time to time. You just download this one and put into this OBO folder of LPP Tiger, and then you are good to go. You can rerun the analysis and you will get the results. Okay, then we get our results. We can first open this summary Excel table. Here we can see the identifications and then the overall score, each separate scores, and additional informations, for example, the 10 time and then the relative intensity of main fragments. And then you can open this HTML report, just it will open in a browser. We can have a look more in detail. So here you have your settings, the major settings you run this experiment and analysis. And then you have this clickable table. You can click on each of them to get these images. in this image is divided into six panels. So you get extracting ion chromatogram, you know where the MS and the MS is taken, and you have the full MS, you see in the, how intense in the MS level, and you have a look of the isotope pattern, and the isotope score is displayed here. And then here is the full MS with this five different scores, which showed before, and then you can have the final score here. And then you can have the zoomed region for the fragments. You see the assignment of the fragments and also the assignment of the neutral losses. And here are the major fragment intensities table. So this is a very fast tutorial about original LPD Tiger, which published on the Bitbucket website. We cover all these major things until the modification fragment times. So we know the modification types. And then we are working on the LPD Tiger version 2 on GitHub. This is the new website for version 2, which is different from version 1. And we are closely collaborating with LipoStar team to try to make a interface between LPD Tiger and LipoStar 2. And the idea is we use LipoStar for high throughput identification of unmodified lipids. This result will be transferred to LPD Tiger to identify oxidized lipids to more oxidation type level or higher. And then we can transfer it back to LipoStar for additional analysis. And then if you have some issues when using LPD Tiger, you have some wishes for the new functions or have some new ideas, please find in this page and submit the new issue. And we are happy to get feedback from all of you. And this work is of course not possible without support from our nice team and my supervisor and our research fundings. And today I'm talking about LPD Tiger. Tomorrow we are talking about lipid links, another tool for the name conversions. And we are happy that lipid links is now supported by lipid maps and provide service from lipid maps website. And thank you for your attention, and I'm ready for questions.